don't know what the young brothers are going through. Y'all don't know what the young brothers are going through. Y'all don't know what the young brothers are going through. Y'all don't know what the young brothers are going through. Y'all don't know what the young brothers are going through. Y'all don't know what the young brothers are going through. Y'all don't know what the young brothers are going through. Y'all don't know what the young brothers
are going through. All right, this time, you know, this is when you kind of, like you say, went on your vacation, got kidnapped, you know.
Hey, I got kidnapped Juneteenth. We had a block party about to do. We was at the store buying, getting everything for the block party. I just had a block party Easter. At the studio, yeah. And see, I was in my prime, so like a lot of people don't know a lot of stuff. Like, you got a lot of street dudes that do their thing. Mm. They just there, but you don't know the grimy dudes, the dudes out there going and get it, come back with it. See, they don't know nothing about that. Mm. Like, you have people used to tell me, like, hey man, that man got Smitty in that audiobook. He don't even know Smitty like that. And I was like, okay, when Pepper come to town, I think I picked her from the airport. I took them shopping, because Smitty ain't gonna have everybody around her. Mm. So I said, the people that said that I don't know Smitty, ask them, have I ever watched Smitty cars? Mm-hmm. Ask them, did Smitty ever see me to go get him a wing dinner? Mm-hmm. I had my own money. So when we have a lick set up, executive staff was on it, allowed to participate in these meetings.
Yeah,
like, you know, when Smith was talking to Cricket and Baby on the North, or some motherfucker out the North, Ryan Gaynor, the Kerry Barnett and them, Arvin with the detail shop. Some of these people, you guys are workers. Mm-hmm. You guys are not allowed to come into an executive staff meeting. But I was there.
Yeah,
yeah. You know, we about to. Dude, so we about to go spend $2 million on some things.
Yeah.
And sell them to somebody, buy the stuff, and return the stuff with some dummy keys. Yeah, so they weren't part of that. We hit licks, y'all was at home. Mm-hmm. Only thing y'all know, Smitty taking like the Mike Tyson fights. Smitty can call back to Houston and get nobody to wire him no $20,000 to $30,000. Mm-hmm. You better ask somebody who he beat at 3 or 4 o'clock in the morning to send that money to Vegas. He was pepping them, capping, and ran out of little change. Mm. I ain't worried about that. I know when he get back, I'm going to get my money back. Mm. Yeah, you can't make it. Ain't, you know, back then, you can just call me, hey, man, you got the paper on you? Yeah, I need about 40. All right. We robbed together. I'm going to get my change back. You know, I'm getting in Cleveland, in my spots, I'm getting, you know, I'm 9-5-1.
Yeah.
And I'm 34, get my cousin them up there. Oh man, blessing me, dog. Mm. Yes, Lord.
Yeah.
Put the church hand up. Yes, yeah. Lord. Put the church hand up, man.
Yeah. So how did you get tied up again, you know, and having to sit down for a little minute?
I'm a good heart person. Mm. You meet some people that tell you, say, man, I met the boy, Keith Babin. I went seeing Keith Babin on Belmont, and I ain't have them. But let me tell you how I got there. We know I got shot near Roger. I ain't had nothing. Nobody went from me nothing. This is how I got caught, got on my feet. This is how I got tied to Smith and Pat and kind of like recovered with Blair help and everything. So I was just a good dude, help everybody. Dudes coming, doing 4.5, took over the city on the south side, had them 325 ounces, because the Colombian I was messing with, so give me things for 10, from 11.5 to 10, to 9.5. I'm killing them. They can't sell nothing, man. Man, Batman got them up for things, them dips for 325. This is before I hit the interstate. Mm. You know. So being that good dude, you know, you like love more, bless his heart. They'll tell you, they come see me. I'm just getting, I got it, just getting it away, man. But you know, cause I was eating out of town, eating. Mm. Oh, yes, Lord, eating. Yeah, stay wet, soaking wet. Gonna get cold. Right? So, had the 2 year TDC in the county jail, missed some people. I'm feeding the whole classification crew in the county jail. Mm-hmm. I'm in the county jail for 2 months. We eating like we out on the street. We got chimichangas coming through the barbecue. You name it, man. The deputy going downstairs and my lady friend bringing all the food. We eating like we outside, dog. Mm-hmm. I'm down to 9. They come get me out the tank at 6. Smitty was in there. Stick was there. They'll tell you I went fed them. They in there eating them sandwiches. I brought niggas some ribs, some chimichangas. Yeah. Man, I can get this. Dog, enjoy yourself, dog. I'm up on an elevator ride by myself.
Yeah.
In the county jail. Yeah. So I met some people and met this boy, man, just heart good. Came out of jail. January, put him on his feet, hand him some money, go get him some car, get him a car, get some kids, something for Christmas. And man, 2-3 months later, man, he come to me, but I'm getting all my money out of town. So when I go, Stick, Pee Wee, Corey, Jimmy Dean, they're my four people. Mm. They got my beer money. That, you know, my shopping money. That's who. You know, I leave them one or two apiece. The rest of them, they on the interstate. Mm-hmm. 200. Shit.
Yeah.
Yeah, the rest of them on the Insta. I'm getting all, yeah, I gotta get all, I'm gonna get all this.
Yeah.
So 50 at a time, man, it was, yes. So helping this boy, man, I ain't wronged you. And he caught me, and they caught me right. Just arguing with street military, mind distracted. Mm-hmm. And this boy pulled up on me, man. I see it and couldn't get out of it. Yep, I see it. I'm trapping you in the conversation. And I said, man, I guess it was this time for me to go. Yep. This boy, come talk to me with a federal agent. Mm. Just talking to me. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and I got to argue with street military. See, street military, they got, you know, cocky. You hear yourself on the radio, and you go, at my one of my block party, talk about, oh, man, then, nigga, you won't be nothing without us. I had to grab the mic. I said, man, did y'all hear what these little boys said? Mm. I got a franchise going on, nigga. Nigga, it was like the NFL got the franchise tag on the motherfucker. I said, I'm a franchise player, nigga. If not the owner of the team, right? I'm already established. Like Megan, Carl Crawford is national.
Yeah.
Carl put Megan out through his nationality. He already national. Megan came up on something national. Mm. I'm already reputational. Keith Babin, South Park, boom, boom, boom. When street military come, now it's street, man, Keith Babin rap group, street military. They don't say street military, they found Keith Babin. It's Keith Babin rap group, street military. My name is like salt and pepper. Salt is always leave than pepper. Where's the salt and pepper? Mm-hmm. It's Keith Babin rap group, street military. That's how they say it.
Yeah.
Right? So I'm getting to with them arguing with them. They don't want to come to the studio. I spend all this money on these boys. Church, you had to go talk to them. You know, now when the people get on me, now... from somebody else. My thing was tight. I'm not out of town. I won't do nothing in Houston. Went on like a year or something, run, nothing. Money was getting stopped on the highway. Girl got the hot curl in the purse coming through the airport with like 200-300. They're taking the money. They're taking them losses. This just happened back to back. I'm like, damn. Yeah, so I just kind of tightened down everything. Then as soon as I tightened it down, what I got caught with, it should have been gone. Mm-hmm. My boy, I ain't gonna say his name, he passed. When my Colombian got arrested in February of 92, it was hard for me to get something. Hanging with Smitty, right? I then had to get butt naked to get something. Mm-hmm. Because you know, I got we got counterfeit money, we sell dummy keys, and we got police.
Yeah.
I ain't snitching. I ain't no snitch. I'm a movie. We had a movie life. Mm. You know, we had Turn Affairs from the Fed, Feds and HPD come ask me try to identify these losses. I told them, I can't spoil you like that. Do your job.
Yeah.
I can't spoil you like that. I don't even know them people. I see them at the club before. I don't know him. I don't know that one either. We eating with these boys, man. I wish I would tell you who they is. Mm. You know what I'm saying? Mm. So, again, If the things leave and go up the highway, when you come ask me, I won't have nothing. Yeah. So the five were left. I sold four of them. That one was left. They all supposed to been gone Tuesday. I got hit Friday, Juneteenth. Mm. If all of them leave Tuesday, I won't have nothing. I would never got arrested. Mm. Did hating? Why hate on me? Jimmy Johnson was the quarterback, was the coach for the Dallas Cowboys. The owner was Jerry Jones. Jerry Jones, this the coach got your franchise team 2-3 Super Bowls. You still getting the, you know, you still getting the credit. You want all the credit, right? He didn't want no money. He won the front. He in the club telling everybody, "Oh yeah, yeah, I'm front Keith Babin. Yeah, I'm giving you anything you want." I had to put, "Hey man, what, you drunk? Got my business out here. Niggas think I got, you know, y'all got a fan base. Y'all don't need my fans knowing, nigga. I'm getting something from somebody. They think I got my own money, right? So what happened? I took you to show you my spots. So you give me 50 at 12 apiece, at $600. You get out of town with me, you see I'm getting 32, 37. We get back, you wanna go up on the price. I ain't tripping. All right. You get drunk and you go to tripping. I had to kind of discipline. You know, Webster said that the word discipline means a system of rules that govern self-control. Did you get that? A system of rules. Yeah, rules. Had to discipline them. Yeah, hurt my hand on that boy, too. Yeah. Yeah, because I told my man, don't never get in my business, dog.
Yeah.
We going to keep it good. And I can get that from nobody, because they say, man, that nigga be respected. They got them laws. The laws ain't on nobody from Houston. We ain't giving nobody name, and he got some. We got niggas coming in from all around the country with $200,000-$300,000 cash. I need you to pull a car, but I need to get that change. Mm-hmm. So we go shopping.
Yeah.
Hello? Since I don't know nothing, oh man, keep that one and all that. Really? I think it was a dope sweater for 2 months. Nobody had nothing. While I was at the car wash tearing up $100 bills, wiping my finger away with money, and grabbed the whole key, broke it in half, and slammed it against the wall at the car wash. Keep Babin got what? Y'all wonder where, how did him and Smitty end up with something? You workers that they know, that say I ain't know Smitty, I think you guys was, y'all was giving and distributed a small portion. I was the manager over that whole operation, sir.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, they ain't getting it. Yeah, but you ain't got a business hurting on me. Smitty say, okay, man, we just hit a $207,000. Okay, yeah, but we paid our people, give what we got. I'm in the mall. North B Leather, we in the mall, shopping. When Pepper come to town, he spent the heaven with one prayer. Asked me any one of them niggas who she was. Yeah, he caught, "Where you at, boy?" I said, "Over here. You got your hair fixed?" I said, "Yeah. Hey, I need to grab Pepper now." All right. Her and them, like three or four of them. Pick them up from the airport in the black van. Fat Pat van, sure did. Mm. Get their hair fixed at the studio, at Tap Masters and everything. You know what I'm saying? But like I say, that heart was good. And helping this boy, like I say, he brought a federal agent to me.
How long did you do?
Oh, 16-10. Mm. Yeah, Obama changed the law, got immediate release.
Did it kind of trip you out when you came back to the city to kind of seeing how different it was?
Oh, yeah. I knew one thing. See, the streets got a structure. Like, you see it on TV all the time. You just can't go just going where you want to go, doing what you want to do. Right, that's how the justice moved. And so they couldn't be back there where we was. They mama, like the name of my movie is called "The Author of My Mama Tears." The mamas would have been crying. We'd have been, them little boys, they wouldn't have made it. Because y'all too hazardous. You know what I'm saying? You got to ask yourself, if you keep the weather bad in the street, young man, how you gonna make some money? If the streets look like a Christmas tree outside, how you gonna work? We was businessmen. The streets, Scott Plaza was a business. You can't go up and walk in Walmart and fire off a 17-round clip if you don't get killed. That's a business. If you go to this restaurant, somebody pistol whip you, you're going to stop going over there. Right? They don't have a business mind. They have like that thug hula mind. They ain't got no morals. The street education is missing. That's why the violence is bad. And like I tell them all the time, I say you ain't never put a white man living in a white man wrapped up in black skin.
Yeah.
Damn, OG, you say we white? I said, yeah, anybody that's of black complexion that hurt another man of black complexion, Malcolm told you that. black people that hurt black people, one of y'all white. Because when a black man hurt another black man, you don't feel nothing. You a white man.
Real quick, man. After the episode of SlabOgsTv, y'all go to volize.biz, man. It's a shoe company based out of Houston. 100% made out of Italy. Hey, man, y'all see it right here, man. Comfortable, easy to walk on, you know what I'm saying? They stylish. Slab Sundays, that's what I'm riding in, man. Free shipping, money back guarantee. So after the episode, y'all go to volize.biz, man. And, man, y'all come down stylish, man. It's sponsoring SlabOgsTv, so you know y'all, if I'm rocking with them, we gotta rock with them, you know what I'm saying? So,
yeah, living in black skin. Had to put the church hand up. Lord help us. And that's what it is. So they don't understand why we were so successful, right? We had a lot of money, right? Wasn't no violent. American gangster come talking. They want some violent. Usually they had no violent. We were, man, we was finessers, dog. Like all my boys coming from out of town, coming to Houston trying to get some 13.5 a thing, right? Let me go fly. Like I told Craig Hicks one time, my boy, bless his heart. Well, he had some boys come out of Baltimore. We gonna flow up there. Yeah, what? 31.5. Y'all don't never need to come back to Houston. Then what we about to do, Craig? We about to sell them 5 at 50 at Houston price. The other 5 or 10, we need 31 for them, and we gonna bring them to them. Boy, I loved us. Anyway, I ain't had no problem with nobody on the interstate, dog. Y'all don't need to come to Houston. Never again. My boy and my cousin, them come from Cleveland or Oklahoma. My people from Louisiana. I flew them down to come have a good time. He come down here to shop. Look, I'm going to take it down. Y'all don't never come back here for nothing. The highest they price was, I'm going to bring mine. I got to go up there. Yeah. And that's what these guys' minds ain't locking in. I'm gonna go take it to you. So you got to come here. Come here, you almost a 12, 13. I get 35, 37 up there. Let me get my road team together. Let me get my 18-wheeler board together. Let me get it up there for you, sir. You ain't got to take a chance with your money. My money is going to get it up there, sir. This is business.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I did them so cold, I sent them 10 at the user price and then 10 at their price. They think they went, man, that's cool. Hell yeah, I'm cool, nigga. I'm cool. But then, like I said, the one's head was hard. I ask, don't come here. They come, buy 10 keys, 15 apiece, $150,000. They go try to rock it up. Hey, man, it ain't rocking. Or 15 dummies. I just feel so. You know, I had a good heart, dog. Mm-hmm. I just look at Smitty, man. The man just didn't got no conscience, man. I said, damn, Smitty. That nigga say, man, shit. We got a nigga to concert this week. Michael Jackson, somebody was in town. That nigga had me rolling, man. I said, man, he said, man, the dude want that money back. He said, yeah, I know. Let's give it back to him. Mm. We get the people back counterfeit money, dog.
Damn.
I had a good heart, dog. Yeah. You know, man, I just see a dead cat. I just go to a dead cat, dead bird. I go to crying, man. Who did that cat like that, dog? A real live killer crying over a dead cat. That's how I was, man. Just a good hearted dude, man. Mm. I can't stand for a dude hitting no woman. I can stand that, but you know.
Yeah.
But what's this? And we got the people. So you 15, so you 10 keys to she ride, pay you back your $150,000 in counterfeit money. You going back to the hotel, you got a girl with you, she driving, you get pulled over. 2 days later, he was up, what's up, man? Man, your boy answered the phone. I said, what's happening? He took care of you, right? He said, yeah, man, I got bad news, man. I said, well, can you talk? I'll come by there. So, you know, I'm strapped. I want my boys with me, make sure you know, suspect something. You know, we 9 minutes, we infrared, 38 round clip in the side. You know, this is business, dog. And people understand that you got to have that business together. I want no bad person. But don't let the smooth taste fool you. But don't hit them send buttons and them go buttons or activate button, and then you worry about what's happened as you got that gorilla coming out. Don't get mad at me because the gorilla don't understand no English. Mm-hmm. He don't got no Texas rules allowed. Mm-hmm. You hit that button. Now your mom and them crying. You did that. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So I go meet the guy, man. It was so cold. We just built them boys out of town. Don't come here. I'm gonna come see you. Don't come here, man. I feel so bad for these people, man. Now the dude trying to get back to St. Louis, Minnesota, Buffalo, where we trying to get back to. I said, damn, dog. I said, what happened? He said, man, this motherfucker girl, I told her, don't, she's driving all crazy, man. The man that pulled us over and took the damn money and wrote, gave us a little piece of paper. I said, no shit, damn, dog. Your money was at North Beach Leather, certain Galleria. Nima's got your money. Your real money. Nima's got it. Chanel purses. Dunenberg luggage. Oh, these people, North Beach Leather, that's our main, one of our main stores. They have your money, your real money, sir. The money you have don't even exist. But before you can see that it was fake money, it was retrieved, recovered, took. Because it's not lawful to have that much money riding around Houston. So they seized it from you and gave you a piece of paper. Hey, call this number about your money. You know you ain't going to call that number. Mm-hmm. So now you come to me, you still need 5-10 keys. I said, man, damn, I need to make something off of that. Hey, man, I'm going to do it, man, this time, man. God damn. So you run, cool. We think already. I got the keys for 9-5 apiece. I ain't tripping if you do run. We got our money. When we spinning, because they wonder how we paint cars every week. This doing a shortage, right? So the boy get where he going, and boy, shit. 2 weeks later, that boy back on his feet, and you know me, damn, what they paying up there? We just hit you for $150,000, nigga. 2 weeks, you back on your feet in buying 10, man. Man, I need to come up there. Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, man, thank you, man. Tipping $5,000. Man, thank you so much, man. Looking out, dog. Real nigga, dog. I like that, yeah. What you doing? Oh, yeah, no, I can't bring you, make sure you got yours. Mine working. Oh, about to say, because we don't have a problem with another one like the other one. Did you get that one?
Yeah. Damn, man. Man,
before you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So this is how, like I say, baby boy, this is how it was, man. People, like I said, they want part of them, like they'll see us buying the drinks. They said it's having fun, this at the club, man, just boom, boom, boom. But they don't know behind the scenes
what's happening.
Man, we was maggots, dog. Man, I used to be so mad myself, man, watching them, looking at them dude, and they heart this man, like they was at a funeral. Open them keys up, man, she rocked.
Yeah,
and I'd be like, damn. I said, "Who you, man? I told you, give me a day or two. Who you call? Man, this girl had me call this dude. I said, I tell you, how you look with him when he was driving? Man, you know I knew who the dude was when he drove. Good heart. I'm sad. Want to get a man back his money, man. He's like, voice cracking. Like he left a funeral.
Yeah.
He said, man. Man, I'm about to have this baby, man. I don't know what to do. I said, yeah. And I can let you. Damn. I just kind of stranger. I'm gonna get my money, dog. Like, man, you good, man. I'm trusting you good, man. Like, yeah. I ain't never had nobody run.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's what it was. And people understand, like, Lynn and all these boys out here, Smith just do these boys so bad, bump them into them at the club. But see, Smitty has hands. Smitty box you. Shoot you, whatever. And so they were scared of Smitty, but you know, they always trying me. I'm bright, got a finger, a little cute nigga. They all want to see what I got. I ain't scared of nobody. You with me. I ain't about to go hurt your mama now. We was straight up fighting. You know what I'm saying? But I'm nice if the open the numbers, you give me a chance. You know what I'm saying? I ain't gonna run. You know, but.
Yeah.
A lot of people love, but I just say, I be hearing people, oh man, got Smitty in that. Yo, that man, we ain't know Smitty like that. I said, yeah, but when Mac was down here in the dually in that motorcycle, Smitty was driving his white dually. I think they were his orange bin. I think I kept it if I didn't know Smitty. I think I kept it in my garage for like 6 months. Yeah.
The orange bins.
Yeah, I kept it for like 6 months. I drove it. I remember I had my orange leather on my white shirt, orange leather white silk shirt. At the Houston restaurant in Smitty Bear. I don't know was anybody else able to keep the car that long for the record. When Smitty got the car done, I was on Belmont. Him and Fat Pat put up in the black van. Man, come ride with us. You jumped in the van, we went right to Southwest Airlines, right to RJ's by the lake. we had the place to do the wide bodies on the beam. Boot Nose car was there, and some other boys I knew out of Dallas had they the 500 SL stretched in with that wide body. Mm-hmm. So Smith was so, you know, he capped too. So I'm in Fat Pat looking. I'm walking with the people. I mean, I'll bring my van up here and shut this thing down. Man, you had me listen to some little Mustang. I said, man, I swallowed. That Mustang ain't ready. Remember them little, with them little woofers, you know, them little 12 woofers in there? I got 10. I'm capping with the van. The whole time, Smitty car, they got Smitty car like on a showcase, dog. Man, when I seen that Batman body on that, I looked at that bean, that orange bean. I said, man, that orange bean with the white inside, with that orange trimming, dog, with white seats, white, orange and white dashboard, oak everywhere, tires this big, like the pictures you seen. Mm-hmm. I had the car, man, what?
Yeah.
Unexplainable, dog.
Yeah.
What? Yeah, but I don't know him like that.
Yeah.
I don't know him.
Yeah.
You can call. I can thank you about 5 years to tell you I woke him up at 3 or 4 o'clock in the morning. And we all went to Western Union to submit them about $40,000. Everybody sent 8 apiece. A friend of mine that was with them, he said, man, I know Smitty told me let's go to Western Union and pick up some money. We ain't know where the money came from. But I don't know him. I got to know him. I'm sending $40,000.
Yeah.
Damn. I don't know him, but ask Fat Pat. You ever run across Fat Williams, the head half master express on Scott, ask him, do I know Keith Babin? He'll tell you.
Yeah.
Smitty, I never seen him with no drugs. Mm. Never. When I was going on Phlox, Glen Iris, I never seen him hand me nothing, dog.
Yo, man. That being said, I always like to ask on my last question, what's your top 5 greatest slabs that you've seen in your era?
But the ones I like, I number one because the classic, that Catfish, YKFY, I'm always gonna love that Impala. Cause he was just, when I seen him at Yates, Worthing, always I seen him, man. He was always, man, just that white hat and that you know, that little head, just, and he just be, it was just something about him and feel, was it feel kind of in the air? I ain't never seen a man car dirty.
Yeah.
Cat is my number one. That blue with that white. I like McGinn and Gordon. Bless his heart. You know, he got killed. That burgundy. Man, it's kind of hard to say, man. My buskin New Yorker, the one with the red rag on it. Oh yeah, I gotta put my own car in there. Now, who else? This when I say that kind of caught my attention, made me turn my head, it's kind of hard because I didn't see nothing like, you know, everybody, it's the same car frame. Me on a slab thing, I think the modification, if a car modified and you didn't, like how Smitty stretched that 500 SEL and put them big tires on that Batman frame. See, that's a head.
Yeah.
I mean, people flagging, man, God, what kind of car this is?
Yeah.
See, that's what I think it'll come, but candy paint on all the different type of Fleetwoods, the Park Avenues, the 98s, all the different cars. I don't think the difference is the paint. You got the same rims, paint job, the same. Inside's clean, it's hard to say, but. Shit, I'm a bono, man. I probably have to beep you back, dog. Cause you know, like, I gotta think. I don't know, man. Like, cause it's some real nice. Damn.
So many.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Cause I think I'm trying to see who candy. Like I liked it. Now, Lil Scotty, slant was clean. Mm-hmm. Corey slant was clean. Mm-hmm. James Beasley slant was clean. Mm-hmm. Right? And I'm talking about niggas got the tie on the trunk. I'm talking about clean. Mm-hmm. Then I go into, on the Fleetwoods, Joe Pete,
Megan Thee Stallion, daddy.
Man, that nigga had a motherfucking that Black Cherry Fleetwood dog. with that motherfucking wine color black, man, with that white top, man, it was ridiculous. Mm. I'm talking nasty. Yeah. And you know, it's kind of cool, but like I said, my, props. He went a slab, but I just say he was a, he takes the neighborhood, Black Farrakhan, my boy.
Yeah.
While we on elbows and bowls, he was in 86, this boy putting up in a big old 500, white snow 500. Everybody, we didn't get into 40s to 91, 92. Mm-hmm. Everybody still, it's everybody. Blair was in the 500 SEL in 86, 87, clean. Mm-hmm. We had the car watching out these elbows on Reading Martin Luther King. Blair with this ghost over here, man.
Is he still locked up?
Oh, yeah, that's my boy. He's still there. Mm-hmm. Black Farrakhan, that's my boy.
Yeah.
So yeah. He, you know what I'm saying? So he went an elbow boat dude, but he stayed six suits. Like I said, I told you, like, these boys was classy. Mm-hmm. These boys, suits, six suits, brim, hats, businessmen. Mm-hmm. Had a different look, you know. But me, I got pistol grips under the bumper, oozes, strapped up. Just wow. Mm-hmm. Right? It's a different. You know what I'm saying? But you know, like I said, when you get them elbow, you know, you want to, you know, that was before the boys started hitting the bumpers of the car. I ain't never went through none of that, because I sure had to hate somebody, because you hit bump back of my car, I ain't about to play with you.
Yeah.
I know you, as you about to, like, all the stuff I heard about the fit the boys with just jacking them elbows and all that, that would have never happened when we was on the street, because you messing the streets up. Mm. You know what I'm saying? From north, south, whatever, you making the streets bad with all that, right? That's crazy. And then we D-boys, and you mess with the streets, you mess with the business, you mess with the business, you messing with the street. So it's one hand in hand. So you dragging cars, you gonna better do all that. Mm-hmm. And see, I'm seeing it for right now, but back then, all was about that. I said it, you ain't better do that.
Yeah.
And, you know, we keep the bun and come like 50 and we got it in power. Oh, we've been doing that. We keep the bundle man with $100,000. The lawyers stay with money in their pockets. Ken Shaffer, they stay with money in their pockets. Because you don't know when you might have to defend yourself or hurt somebody. You know what I'm saying? But when you have guys waking up, bumping cars, jacking elbows, you're not a classy nigga, dog.
Yeah.
You're a hoodlum, a thug.
Yeah.
Nigga, I had rolls and rolls. You just came to my garage and got every set you wanted. Nigga, I stayed with low profile this in the garage. And the feds came, I'm like, what's up with all the rim? Man, do what y'all gonna do, dog. You see, acting my damn rim.
Yeah. Man, before we get up out of here, you got any shout outs?
Well, I should shout out, start with, you know, my number one boy, man. You know, shout out to they Flavor, rest in peace, man. You know, Lynn, Smith, Pretty Mike. You know, these some boys that I was close to, Fat Pack Hawk, some other people I know that this past my boy Lil Scotty, stay up boy, that's my people. It's a lot of names I probably don't, but you know what I'm saying. I'm just Bobby McAfee. He was one of my coordinators. Mm-hmm. You know, when the people ask me like, who made the name Keith Babin, you know, I got the Roger Rabbit, I got Bobby McAfee. I got Ricky Brown, you know, I got Blair Freyacon. These people that helped build the name Keith Babin from the, you know, all these, a lot of people that ain't here today. But, you know, we was cool. My little partner, my little boy, Hillman, bless his heart. A lot of people, man, you know, number one, my pops, good man, mm-hmm. You know, this and that. Send a shout to everybody, man, that's been there for me, supported me. I was gone when I was kidnapped for 16 years, they were still there. Some people still respecting me right now today. A lot of people just trying to get behind me with my movement. My family, most important, always there for me. Everybody successful, you know, I'm still the black sheep, always trying something.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Always. Kid Rossi, killer cat, right? But like, man, like I said, man, this a special shout out to anybody. A special shout out to anybody want to be better than what they was yesterday. But like I said, my only thing I want to say to all the viewers and listeners out there, we got to stop killing us. We got to stop us being against us, right? Once we stop that, we'll see a better movement. We'll see a better time when dudes can be able to, the park can go back to the being for the kids. Like I broke my arm on the monkey bars. I ain't seen no monkey bars in so long. The merry-go-round, get these little kids back to parks, man. We had them, but it's so much violence. Like I tell people all the time when they say, how can we stop the violence, the street violence? Well, first of all, if you don't kill that white man that's living inside them black men, you'll never stop it. Mm. The enemy, as T.D. Jakes said best, the enemy is the enemy. So I look at the mirror in the morning, brushing my teeth, I got to always remember, it's not the man in the mirror that's going to be your problem. It's the mirror that's in the man. And I'm going to leave this with you. The best gift in life that you ever can have is knowing who to trust.
Man, I heard it here, man. This is a legend, a Houston legend. You know what I'm saying? Hey, man, if you ain't heard the audio book, go check it out. South Park, A Changing View. He gonna come out with a movie soon, you know what I'm saying?
I can talk 2 more months, but I know we got that.
Yeah, man, y'all heard it here. This is a legend. Like, I mean, y'all see it in the pictures in the intro. Y'all heard it in the stories. I mean, everything he's speaking is facts, you know what I'm saying? So, without further ado again, we got Keith Babin up here. It's Lil WB, SlabOgsTv, we out.